I'm Professor Savita Bodke, and very welcome to the quick revision series of Business Economics 2. Now, in the today's lecture, we are going to study regarding the first chapter, that is macroeconomics. We are going to study meaning, scope, and importance of macroeconomics. As already, we all are aware that economics is having two branches. One is a microeconomics and another is macroeconomics. So macroeconomics is the branch of economics that studies the behavior and performance of an economy as a whole. It focuses on the aggregate changes in economy such as unemployment, growth rate, inflation, etc. Microeconomics deals with the individual factor, but the macroeconomics is having a wider scope because it is going to focus on the large variables. Now we are going to understand the definition of macroeconomics. So we are going to study the definition given by the Professor J. Hansen. Professor J. Hansen says that macroeconomics is the branch of economics which considers the relationship between the large aggregates. Please remember that. Which considers the relationship between large aggregates such as volume of employment, total amount of savings, investment, national income, etc. So you have to remember the two points, that is branch of economics and large aggregates in this definition. Now the next one is scope of macroeconomics. In this we have to remember a 7 points, that is study of aggregate, national income, inflation, employment, growth rate, consumption and saving, and rule of money. So now we are going to understand the first point of your scope of macroeconomics. Study of aggregate. Macroeconomics studies the national level issues and the problems. Why it is studies the national level issues and problems? Because it is having a wider scope. Now the next one is, second point is national income. Second point is national income. Macroeconomics tells you about the different theories, importance, method of calculations, and key determinants of the national income. Now the third point is inflation. Macroeconomics tells you about the causes, the measures to control the inflation, and what are the negative impact of the inflation on your national economy. So inflation, that is causes, measures to control the inflation, and negative impacts of the inflation. Now the next point is employment. Macroeconomics discuss the different theories of the employment. And what are that theories? That is classic theory, Keynesian theory, and modern theory of employment. Now the next one is growth rate. Macroeconomics again deals with the different theories of growth. It explains the importance of the growth. Again, the macroeconomics is helping you for the formulating the policies. So with the help of such type of policies, you can achieve the higher growth rate. Now the next one is consumption and savings. Macroeconomics is also studies the different theories of consumption and savings. It also states the importance of the saving, that is why the saving is important for your nation. Now the next one is role of money. Macroeconomics explains the role of money and its importance for the economy. It explains the different concepts associated with the money. So what are that concepts? Investment, inflation, savings, all these concepts macroeconomics is explaining you. So till now we have studied regarding the meaning, definition and scope of your macroeconomics. Again, I'm going to repeat the few things. We have first studied regarding the meaning of macroeconomics. Please remember that it is a branch of economics which is having a wider scope because it is going to focus on the large variables such as your unemployment, growth rate, inflation, etc. Then we have studied regarding the definition of macroeconomics. In that also we have remembered that it is a branch of economics which studies the relationship between large aggregates, and large aggregates are your employment, savings, investment, national income, etc. Then we started with the scope of macroeconomics. We have to remember the 7 points. The first one is study of aggregate. It is study of aggregate because it studies the national level issues and problems. Now the next one is national income. So in this we have to remember that macroeconomics tells about the different theories, importance, methods of calculation and key determinants. Now the next one is inflation. Macroeconomics tells you about the causes of inflation, measures to control the inflation and negative impact of the inflation on your economy. Now the next point is employment. In this you have to remember that macroeconomics explains the different theories of employment. And what are that theories? Classic theory. Next one is, classical theory, Keynesian theory and modern theory of employment. Now the next one is the growth rate. Macroeconomics explain the different theories of growth rate. It states the importance of growth in your economy, and also it is helping you to formulate the policies to achieve the good growth rate. Now the next one is consumption and saving. Macroeconomics also studies the different theories of consumption and saving. It also telling you the importance of saving, why the saving is important for the nation. Now the next one is role of money. It is explaining you the role and importance of the money, and it also explains you the different concepts associated with money such as investment, inflation, savings. All this are related with your money. Now the next one we are going to study, that is importance of macroeconomics. Importance of macroeconomics. In this we are having 10 points. The first one is functioning of an economy, formulation of economic policies. Third one is understanding the macroeconomics. Fourth one is understanding and controlling the economic fluctuation. Fifth one is inflation and deflation. Next one is study of national income. Seventh point is study of economic development and growth. Next point is helpful in understanding the macroeconomics paradoxes. Next one is nature of material welfare. And the next one is economic planning. So now we are going to discuss this in detail. What is the importance of your macroeconomics? Now the first one is functioning of an economy. Macroeconomics analysis is very important because it plays very important role in the functioning of your economic system. How it is playing a very important role in functioning of your economy? Because it always deals with the large variables such as your employment factor, national income, growth rate, etc. Now the next importance of your macroeconomics is formulation of economic policies. Macroeconomics always helping in the formulation of economic policies. Why it is helping in the formulation of economic policies? Because in case of the macroeconomics, we study about the large variables like your national income, employment, investment. So all these factors are having an influence on your economic policies. So that's why the macroeconomics is helping you in the formulation of economic policies. Now the next one is understanding microeconomics. As we have already discussed that economics is having the two branches. One is the microeconomics and another is the macroeconomics. Right now we are discussing about the importance of macroeconomics. But your macroeconomics is helping you to understand the macroeconomics. How? Because to study the macroeconomics, it is essential to have the proper understanding of your microeconomics. If you want to formulate any policy, so you should have the better understanding of microeconomics. So that's why it is one of the importance of your macroeconomics. Now the next one is understanding and controlling the economic fluctuation. Understanding and controlling the economic fluctuation. Macroeconomics is always helps for the controlling and understanding the different economic fluctuations. For example, it is going to help you to understand the causes in the fluctuation of income, your employment, output, or the growth rate. Now the next point is inflation and deflation. Inflation means rises in the prices of commodities, and deflation means the reduction in the prices. So inflation is increase and deflation is the decrease in the prices. So macroeconomics plays a very important role in understanding the inflation and deflation, because all these two factors, inflation and deflation, is having its own impact on the different groups of the economy. Because if there will be the increase in prices or decrease in prices, it is going to affect on your value of money. Again, the macroeconomics is helping you to reduce the adverse impact of your inflation and deflation on your entire economy. Now the next one is study of national income. As the macroeconomics always deals with the large variables or the large aggregate, it plays very important role in the study of national income. Now the next one is study of economic development and growth. Always your economic development is majorityly based on the large variables, and macroeconomics is studying the large variables or the large aggregates of your economy. So your macroeconomics plays the very important role in study of economic development and growth. Now the next one is helpful in understanding the macroeconomic paradoxes. What is the meaning of macroeconomic paradoxes? It refers to those concepts which hold a good for the individual, but when they have applied to the all the people, their validity becomes the doubtful. Means if you are going to apply a particular concept for the one individual, it will work for the one individual. But whenever the same concept, if we are going to apply for the entire economy, then we are not sure that whether that concept will work out or not. That is called as your macroeconomic paradoxes. So your macroeconomics is helping you in understanding the macroeconomic paradoxes. Now the next one is nature of material welfare. Macroeconomics plays very important role in studying the nature and size of material welfare of the nation. Now the next one is economic planning. Macroeconomics is studying about the large variables or large aggregates. That's why the entire economic planning is possible. So we have done with the entire chapter, and here in front of you we are having a quick revision. What we have studied, regarding the meaning, we have studied regarding the definition of macroeconomics, we have studied regarding the scope of macroeconomics, we have studied regarding the importance of macroeconomics. I hope that the concept of macroeconomics has been cleared to you within a shorter time period. So all the best for your studies. Keep watching my channel for the further chapters. Thank you so much.